to take it from some sort of drawings or something that we have here and all done and then turn it into something real, I mean, that's it. That's what it's all about. And the students, you know, they come here and they sit in class for years or whatever. They need to realize that too. They need to realize that in the end, it's about turning some idea into some sort of reality and seeing it work. And seeing all the problems associated with making it work, I think is really kind of an eye-opener for them. So it's good, it's great. That's really what it's all about.
I think it's a big part of my education because, like I said, it's not something I'm going to be able to learn in the classroom. This is a very unique experience that I'm very lucky to be able to participate in. You know, I'm learning a lot about the design process, as well as all the steps of good engineering design.
Today we're focusing on the electrical end of the system downstream of the turbine. So the wind turbine generates electricity, and the kind of electricity it generates is not very well regulated. It changes in magnitude, it changes in frequency, it's not something you can really use. So that involves a couple different components. One of them is turning the essentially AC frequency that's generated from the wind turbine, which, like I said, is not uniform, it varies, rectifying that into a DC type of voltage, and then passing that through an inverter that then creates something that can sync up to the grid. So this is the generator that we have sitting on top. This is just a temporary structure so that we can do some mock-up. Essentially, we're mocking up the entire system here in the lab. The generator, the rotor in the hub, all the electrical downstream. So to kind of give you some idea, this is a template for one of the blades. So it would go on something like this. But this is just the wooden template. We're actually having the blades made by a company in Schenectady, and they should be ready within a month or so. We're enclosing it with this duct that you see here on the floor, which has been made by one of our alumni, Thomas Baum, class of 69. And he produced this in his shop down in Little Falls, near Utica, New York. And so he's been working with us, which is really quite exciting. So in conjunction with the whole electrical downstream aspect of it, we have this, I guess you could say, more mechanical build phase that we're working on here right now.